Hey everybody, it's me, Cyborg War. How's my favorite people doing? I'm on Daymar. And I'm about to check out another cave here near Eagle Flats. Survival shelter. Basically, if you go to Eagle Flats and go on heading zero and head out about 10.4 kilometers and turn around, and then if you're facing back towards Eagle Flats, I don't know why I keep calling it Eagle. Eagle Flats, it's on 176 at like 10.2 to 10.3 kilometers. And you'll see it. It's a really small hole. I found it in the dark, so I'm assuming in the daylight, it'll be pretty easy to see. All right, let's go in and see what we got. I want to thank everyone, our channel members and subscribers. You guys are amazing. We have over 2,000 subscribers now. Something I never thought would be possible back when I started this stupid little YouTube channel. But thank you so much. You guys are amazing. All right, so this is supposed to be a glowing rock cave. Ooh, I can already see the little mushrooms down there growing. Ooh-hoo-hoo. These were in Pyro, so I've been in them before, and they're really beautiful. My cinema camera is still messed up, so I can only just like rotate around my character. I can't really move my camera backwards and forwards and whatnot. Thank you to everyone who watched the last video we just did for the acidic caves. Ooh, there's loot in here. There wasn't loot in the other one. Anything good in there? Nope. But I'll take it. I wonder if this will be a magical cave like that one cave we had out here on Daymar. This stuff kept spawning over and over and over again. You make like 500,000 credits an hour. Here's some ephorite. I'll take that. PTU, not like it really matters, but it's good to know that they put loot in this cave. It is Daymar after all, so they're probably trying to make the pirates salivate about hanging out here. Or there could be pirates in the cave for all I know. I haven't seen any other ships around here at all, so that one can't be opened. A lot of that going on with the boxes since they started the Halloween mask thing. Oh, look at this. Whoa. It's so cool. I hear little droplets of water going, and there's like little rocks falling. I haven't seen any kind of ore deposits yet, so I'm always on the lookout for Janolite, and I know they have a whole bunch of new resources coming into the game, and whether or not they're already in or if they're coming to 4.0. There's going to be a lot of new stuff to mine as we get ready for outposts and bases and whatnot. Different things, resources you're going to need, materials to build. I hear the last server meshing test, I think it was what, the test number 5, which I actually had a really decent experience on. Went pretty well. The 1,000 person test, I don't think went well, but the 500 person, it was like 4 servers, 500 people, so it was like each server hit 125. It was really stable, and that was what I was on, and I honestly, if it wasn't for seeing all the people everywhere, I wouldn't even had noticed we were in server meshing. But I heard that one went well. They got a lot of the data. They were looking for the bottlenecks for the 1,000 server or 1,000 player server. shards. So hopefully in the next test we can get this sorted. So this cave is mapped as well automatically in your mini-map. I assume that's going to change when they bring in player scanning. You'll have to like scan it when you get in there. But for right now, I think they have it turned on. Ah, this is so cool. I don't know if there's any copians or anything down here, but I guess we'll find out if there are. I haven't seen any more loot boxes since those initial ones by the entrance. Wow. Look at, like, are those, like, spores coming off of it? It looks really cool. Are those spores or little life forms? I think they're just spores floating. I love it. Hey, there's another loot box. There's a couple. Looks like there's another one over there, too. All right, let's check it out. You never know what you're going to find. I got Dolivine, Ephorite. Nothing else that I need. I like that little grotto there with just mushrooms inside of it. Check this other box and then we'll go down there. A loot goblin and me just can't let stuff sit. Here we go. So you can put flares down on the ground, but they only last for a few minutes. At least they used to. I might have changed that, but putting flares on the ground, they would last about 5 minutes, which was kind of defeating the purpose of using them to finding your way back. So actually, in some of the big caves, I have taking the fruit I find in the loot boxes, or I bring some with me, and I just drop them along a trail. And it's like a trail of breadcrumbs, but it's the little blue fruits. And I just leave them, and then when I come across one, I'm like, all right, this is the way back. But with the mapping system, probably don't need to do that anymore. But them old caves, man, I used to get so lost in the old caves. So if I go down there, will I die? No. Okay. Looks like I do something here. I thought maybe I'd just get stuck in a hole and never be able to get out. Ooh. These cool little tunnels down here. Perfect spot for predator ambushes. Lots of Dolivine, some Rantidung. Cool if they had special type of like a treasure missions or something to here, or you gotta like solve a puzzle or follow clues to a path. You can have your own little Goonies adventure in Star Citizen. Look at that. Lord. Lord have mercy. That's so pretty. This cave's a lot quieter than the last cave I was in. I think that... I don't know. That might be the way... No, that's not the way I came in. It might be, because this might be the same box. Yeah, it's the one I took the Dolovan out of. Okay. Yeah, you can just climb right up there. It's not the same hole, but I was able to get out of it pretty easily. Able to vault over this. Alright. They did a pretty decent job of allowing you to move around, get in and out of the little areas. I was gonna say, I think we might be having a server error again. Unfortunately, those are still a fact of life here in the PTU. I think once we get server, well, I bet when we start server meshing in the live, we're still gonna have quite a bit of issues with crashes and stuff and performance until they get it all sorted up. And that's just how it goes. You know, we're basically playing a dev build until we're told otherwise. So they have a new promotional thing out there for jump gates. CIG did. Here, I'll throw the video up right now. People are saying because the jump gate is blue on the other side, it might be to another system besides Pyro. So it could be going back to Stanton. You never know. Or, as some people have suggested, it could be Nyx. And CIG has seemed to have... put the chum in the water for that. Because they're dropping hints in Spectrum about a new system, and they were using quotes from this promo before the promo went out. So we'll see. If Levski is back, I'm gonna freak out. And the fact that Pyro goes directly to Nyx, I think Pyro has like 7 jump gates in it, and one of them goes to Nyx. And Nyx, the system Nyx itself, doesn't have much in it. Yeah, so it's an easy system to bring back, bring in. Even if it's just a place to go explore with no real missions or anything right off the bat. They could definitely drop Nyx in with Pyro if they want. Because, I mean, if they're looking to get to 1.0 pretty quick, they're going to have to start dropping systems in. And from what the rumors I heard from internal memos that have been leaked from people at CIG is they're looking to have 5 or 6 systems ready to go at 1.0. Oh baby, look at this stuff. Like the Overlord Stinger. Alright. New helmets. All right. I always need new helmets and stuff for my PTU account. since I had to do a wipe not too long ago to get it to work. I lost everything I had been collecting for a while. Not like it matters in the PTU, but it's cool to have new clothes, you know? It's just something else to wear while you're out exploring. Man, this is so beautiful. I think I like the acid caves better. But this is definitely not bad. Yeah, so back to jumps. So if Nyx, you know, take it with a grain of salt, there's no confirmation of it yet. Maybe at CitizenCon they'll say they'll have Pyro and Nyx. Who knows? We'll see. If not, I just want Pyro, honestly. Just let's get it done. It's been long enough. But if they do announce Nyx, I'm going to freak out because Levski was my favorite place of all time to visit. And since it's been gone now for a few years, been at least, I think, about 3 years. I'm stuck on something. Oh, I'm stuck here. I'm stuck on some kind of weird geometry. I'm floating in the air. There's some kind of barrier here that shouldn't be here. Maybe I can go this way. No, that led to nowhere. Ooh, if I go down this way, it's like it's not disconnecting from this hill up here. I'm stuck. All right. I don't know what to do. I've found an invisible geometry in the cave. Let's see where we're at. So right here, coming down, it looks like to be the edge of the end of the cave. See, in this area, and there's an invisible geometry. Let's take some pictures of this. I can submit it to the issue council. I don't know the name of this cave. I wish they would put the names of what it is you're looking at, but here it's got my position and everything, so hopefully that'll help them. Can't move my camera, but here. I really need to set up my cinematic controls again. All right, folks. Well, that's the cave. I think I'm stuck here for good. I don't think I'll be able to get out. I'm going to have to backspace. Or I'm just going to exit the menu, actually. And that way I'll just reappear back at Everest. I think it was my last port of call. I was going to set my spawn at Seraphim, and I forgot. See if I can't clip through it. I can't. I guess I'll just leave my ship here. All right, well, that's cave exploring. That's PTU. That's just bugs you encounter, man. They have become unplayable at certain times. All right, this is CyberGore. I love you guys. I'm signing off. We saw about half the cave, I'd say, or maybe even more. I love you guys. You guys take care, and we'll be back with another episode soon. Peace.